This week on American Airgunner, we'll travel to Tulsa, Oklahoma to check out one of the largest and nicest shooting ranges in America, the U.S. Shooting Academy. I'll meet up with our friend Mike Seeklander for some self-defense tips and a lot of fun. We'll talk to the guys at the round table, and we'll watch our four remaining contestants battle it out in the challenge we like to call the Shredder. It's all coming up right now on American Airgunner. Hey, Mike.
Hey, how are you, man? Nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's good to meet you. I appreciate you having me out.
Well, welcome to the U.S. Shooting Academy. This is probably the premier training place in the U.S. They do everything from concealed carry to self-defense training to rifle, shotgun, handgun. They have a full set of competitive range. They hold the national matches here, so this is a great place to train.
Okay, well, then I want to do everything. What am I going to get to do today?
Today, we can't quite do everything in one particular day, but sure. I know you know your background is air guns, and you've been around a lot with the show, but today we're going to focus on some things you probably haven't done. That's self-defense related training with an airsoft and air gun. And so we're going to talk about that as well as using an air gun for self-defense, the pros and cons.
Well, I've got minimal skills, so let's go, and I can't wait to see what you can teach me.
Let's go, man.
All right, brother. After checking out some of the awesome ranges at USSA, it was time to get to the good stuff. Mike taught me some techniques on how to protect my family in case of a home invasion, how to search and clear a room, what's wrong with the tactical stuff we see on TV and movies, and finally, the big question, what about air guns for self-defense? Obviously, I've got a lot of knowledge here on air guns, airsoft guns, but this airsoft gun looks very similar to this gun. Talking about this.
Yeah, this bad boy is actually my JP rifle. This is my home defense rifle. This is a real firearm, live firearm, obviously. Mm-hmm. This is something that I've set up for home defense if I were to need a home defense type rifle. And the thing is that I wanted to show you the similarities. If you're training with airsoft or, air guns of any kind, there's probably one that's made that's identical or very similar to your live firearm, which once again, because we're on the live fire range, doesn't necessarily mean we got to go live fire.
Right.
We shot 100 rounds out of this today, that'd be pretty expensive. We could shoot hundreds of BBs all day long and practice and work around cover and do a lot of different things with this gun and spend a few dollars.
Right.
The critical component in training, and I train literally hundreds of people a year, is comfort. Mm-hmm. And when I get a brand new shooter or a shooter that's just not comfortable picking up, an M4 type system, they're loud. They don't recoil a lot, but they're loud. They can be scary. I can put an airsoft gun or an air gun in their hand and let them shoot it all day long and they start to have fun. And one of the things about that is when people are having fun, man, they're learning. They're enjoying themselves.
Sure.
And that's the concept of using airsoft and training, air guns and training, because it increases the fun factor. When we're talking about systematic training, we have dry fire, which is basically if I took any kind of firearm, it's unloaded, I draw it, and I can get that click. The next level is to use airsoft or air-type guns. So I've actually got the BBs or the pellets going downrange or the plastic BBs going downrange. Now I can actually affirm hits on the target. I know if what I'm doing is working, and I'm having fun with it. This is a 6mm BB airsoft gun. Uh-huh. It actually has a magazine that looks identical to a live magazine. So if we were to load it, it would look just like this.
Right
now, this is how the gun comes stock out of the box. So if I wanted to mimic my home defense gun, I'd simply, maybe add an optic sight. This actually has sling mounts on it. It has a collapsible stock, so I can do all of the same things that I can with my live firearm. As a matter of fact, literally the stock on this particular gun, when I got it from Umarex, came exactly like the stock on my live gun. So when I'm practicing, my cheek weld, or I'm working around cover and I'm doing different positions, which I like to practice, I can practice it with this gun all day long. And if you look at the rest of the guns, man, I carry a Smith & Wesson M&P. So if I have, this is once again, a CO2 pistol. This is exactly the same size as the carry gun that I carry. Mm-hmm. And what that does is it allows me to holster it up in my carry holster, and it fits just like my normal carry gun. So I could practice my draw process or techniques or whatever I want with this gun and once again spend pennies, do it very, very safely. Mm-hmm. I could shoot in my garage, set up some sort of safe backstop and have
right.
Lots of fun training, and the more I train, the more I learn how to access that firearm, the better I'm going to become.
Up next, it's the round table. Stay tuned. American Airgunner is sponsored by Umarex, Zeroed In, and Pyramid Air, the world's largest retailer of air guns. It's roundtable time with my guys, Rick Eutsler, Jim Chapman, Tom Gaylord. Guys, this is going to be fun because today we're talking about one of my favorite things about air guns. We're talking CO2 technology.
When we were talking about guns before, one of the things we mentioned was the single shot. Mm-hmm. You know, the single shot break barrels, for example. What's cool about this gun, it's multi-shot. And that's a huge advantage with the CO2 guns is that this is more like a traditional firearm.
Right, okay, but hold on. Before we get into that, because I know, because I think that's the beauty of a lot of these guns, I want to get back to this feet per second with the pistols and with the rifle. From a hunting aspect, what kind of game can you go after with a 400 to 600 feet per second versus like an 850 feet per second? What can you use that for?
I wouldn't really use the lower velocity for hunting. I mean, you might be able to do mice around the barn or whatever.
Sure.
But a gun like the Hammerly, I think you could use that for rabbit and squirrel pretty effectively, a 30-yard gun.
Okay.
I mean, it's generating the same type of velocity and energy that you're getting with some of the mid-power and lower-power springers, which have been used very effectively for years to hunt small game. Mm-hmm. So I'd say you're looking at a good all-around 30-yard small game gun.
Long as you're in warm weather.
Yeah, that's actually the catch there, is that these guns are very temperature sensitive. I've actually gone out in cold weather. I go to shoot my gun and the pellet just about falls out of the end of the barrel.
Really?
Yeah, and on the other hand, I've gone into very hot climates to hunt out in the deserts to go rabbit hunting. And there's a vapor lock almost with the gun, a valve lock.
And what is the valve lock?
The gun doesn't shoot.
Yeah, well, valve lock, okay. You know, that 900 PSI mark is within a certain temperature range. Mm-hmm. You drop below that temperature range and that pressure drops, or that's why your velocity drops. Mm-hmm. You go above that temperature range and your pressure goes up. And when your pressure goes up, you got a hammer spring that's hitting a valve in this gun that then opens the valve, lets the CO2 go out, okay? When you have a lot of pressure coming this way, it's gonna hold that valve really shut. So the hammer spring hits it, it just bounces off.
It doesn't too much pressure.
Too much pressure in the gas, and you get what's called valve lock.
You can actually lock a gun up by laying it in the sun on an 80-degree day.
Yeah.
And if the sun just beats down on it.
If you do that, the solution is put the gun in the shade for about a half an hour, and it'll operate again.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
But it leads me to wonder, if I was going to use this for hunting out in hot climates, could I tune a gun up so that it operated more effectively at the higher pressure?
Well, just what he said, you're going to have a range. You can tune it up, but all you get is a range that's higher.
Well, it'd only be a hot weather gun.
So, which brings me to an interesting question. If you can keep these things loaded, and you can keep the air or the CO2 cartridge in them,
yes,
can you use them for home defense?
Absolutely not.
Really?
Yes. Unless you want to make somebody really
mad. Yeah, exactly.
No, it would be a threat. I mean, the kind of people you would be defending yourself from are not the kind of people who would be threatened by a gun.
But you're trying to tell me someone walks in my house and I go,
what if he comes at
pulls
you?
Pulls something at you?
First off, look at the cylinder. You can tell what it is, that it's not a firearm.
Sure.
But any time you would use in a defense situation,
an
air gun. Yeah, but if you had to actually use it.
Yeah, and he's hopped up on angel dust.
Sure.
PCP. He's going to keep coming, and when he finds out it's an air gun, you're in trouble.
Oh, yeah, you've just made them that much more angry.
But these are great for training for defense.
Right. Yeah.
They're great to train for drawing, for sight control, for trigger control, breathing control. They're excellent for that. A lot of these weigh the same as their firearm counterpart.
So if someone's never, isn't familiar with guns at all, maybe they want to take a course, or again, a young child, you're coming, you want to get them comfortable with guns, these are great.
Excellent.
Women who aren't used to guns, these are great to get them,
the
gun in their hand, how they work. Because most of these, which I love, are replicas of real firearms.
Yes, they are.
Absolutely.
And they're quiet, there's no recoil. I mean, that's how I taught my kids to shoot.
They're inexpensive to shoot.
Yeah. You can shoot
there's so
the
much
big plus
more.
Right there.
Yeah. I actually got a chance to go meet Mike Seeklander, who is a home defense expert, and he told me a little bit about not only home defense, but home defense with air guns. When we come back, we'll see what he has to say. If you guys want any more information on these guns right here, check out these guys' websites. We'll be right back. All right, it's time for our American Airgunner Trivia, brought to you this year by our friends at Blue Book Publications. We'll be right back.
Airguns. Spend less, shoot more. Pyramid Air.
A legend in innovation and tradition. These classical and modern masterpieces have sent pellets downrange for over three decades. German engineered to last a lifetime. Quality, power, precision. RWS, the world's finest air rifles.
I'm going to teach you how to draw a handgun out of that appendix carry position you're wearing, and that's you're kind of mimicking what I'm doing today. So if you want to go ahead and holster up.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and holster up with this firearm. Make sure your fingers are off the trigger when you're holstering up.
Yep.
Be nice and safe there. Cover it up, because we're going to be practicing from concealed, because the average self-defense shooter out there, civilian, they're probably going to be concealed.
Sure.
And let's go down range and work some drill. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a very simple drill from a position I call the high ready. Okay. And the high ready is a position where we've got the grip on the handgun,
uh-huh.
and we're at a position where we pull the handgun back toward our body. What I want you do is go, let's go ahead and take the handguns out.
Okay.
We're both loaded here.
Mm-hmm.
High ready position. Number one, the principle with the grip is the strong hand is going to be nice and high on the handgun itself. Second hand of the gun is going to be nice and high. So I say that trigger guard, my fingers, that's where my index finger is going to hit, and I'm going to roll my grip in there, and notice how both thumbs are now pointed forward. So yeah,
okay.
Move your bit. Now, what that's going to do when I shoot a live firearm is that's going to allow me to get my left hand on the left grip panel and control the recoil as good as I possibly can.
Okay.
So from a high ready position, we have a good athletic stance, fingers off the trigger, because right now we're not ready to shoot. Front sight has to be in the center of the rear sight, perfect alignment,
mm-hmm.
in the center of the high chest of that particular silhouette target. Okay?
High chest.
High chest.
Okay.
Front sight. So I'll demo what we're going to do. All we're going to do is we're going to extend the gun. Front sight in the center of the high chest, press the trigger and follow through.
I'm extending.
Extend the gun. Good. So the next drill I want you to watch is we're going to work a progression drill from the holster.
Okay.
So from whatever hand start position you are, you're going to draw the handgun and you're going to fire a shot. And you're going to do it about that fast.
So here, yeah, right.
Once again, you're going to draw the handgun and fire a shot.
Okay.
Okay. You ready to go?
But hold on.
We'll take it a little slower. You're going to go slower, man. Take your time.
Let's see. I'll try it once fast and see how it goes.
Don't try it fast. Okay, whatever.
So,
you're right, Ross. Try it fast. Go ahead. It's just an air.
Okay.
Don't be going.
So here we go.
Okay.
I'm all of a sudden nervous. All right, here we go. So I get
there you go.
Okay. This is not going to go well, but I'm going to give it a shot.
Okay. And safety.
I put the safety on.
Went the opposite. It was close though. Once again, so close to
that's
perfect.
Nuts,
the only thing else I saw is your grip wasn't kind of quite.
I didn't
finalized.
Get that. Yeah,
exactly.
I felt that.
Now here's the deal. That you, when
right.
you. It's funny, you're like, hey, let's go fast. Everybody wants to go fast, and the neat thing about airsoft and air guns is you can go fast and do some things that I would tell you are probably not safe in live fire training.
Sure.
However,
I would not feel comfortable at all doing this with live fire.
Absolutely not, and that's why it's a great place to start. However, for today, though, let's build good training habits and good repetition. Slow it down.
Okay.
You know, work through good index points. Make sure you're doing everything you need to do to draw the handgun and get a shot on target. Okay?
Okay.
All right. And then I'm going to give you a little trick.
Okay. Here we go.
Shots, okay?
Yeah.
Good.
I shot him in the shoulder.
Fix the grip.
Ah, man, those thumbs.
Now, here's the difference. You could be dry firing these drills with your live firearm at home,
uh-huh.
but you wouldn't get feedback like that. You wouldn't know, man, I just shot, you know, one shot in the shoulder and one shot in the lower pelvic area. That's not going to have any effect on a person in your house trying to hurt you.
Right.
You know, so that's the benefit of using airsoft and air.
Well, touching. Yeah, let's be honest. I've done the, you know, kind of just dry fire with, that's not fun.
It's not nearly as fun.
I mean, at least I have some frame of reference here, and I'm actually shooting a gun, which is fun.
Right, yeah. And imagine
because I totally missed that first. I might have just skimmed him. He's still coming. The good thing I was taking two shots.
Yeah, no kidding. That second shot follow-up, that saved you, man. All right, dude, what do you want to do? You want to do some, let's do some draws, man. Let's do some fast draws.
Some draws?
Yeah, so you against me.
I'm going to get serious.
We're still
here.
Loaded up. You've been practicing your draw. We've been working all day.
All right.
Now you can beat the master.
Yeah.
Right?
Here.
Okay, so you got your target, I got mine. We got to get a hit in the center of the target, that center square. And we'll start from where? Do you want to start just hands, or do you want to like in front of us, like we're in a defensive
Can
position?
Can I start like that?
Yeah, man. Yeah, you can have yours uncovered.
It's no longer concealed.
Unconcealed if you want. And so we'll say hands up, and then you're the guy saying go.
I'm the guy saying go?
You can say go. Whenever you're ready, man.
Okay. Whoa. Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
Ha-ha! That was pretty good, man. Pretty good.
The shirt helped.
You're going to give me a do-over, though.
You ready?
Yeah.
Go. Look at my grip.
You have a good grip.
My grip's horrible. Training with an expert like Mike today was great. But remember, the most powerful weapon you have when it comes to self-defense is your brain. Use it. And always sign up for professional firearm handling courses even before you purchase. All right, if you want more information on home defense and self-defense, check out AmericanAirGunner.com. We have links to Mike's website so you can find out how you can sign up for a class and what he's got going on, all that good stuff. And of course, more information on the guns that we shot today that I shot a little bit better than Mike.
Did I hit the hole?
Did you go through the same hole?
I didn't go through it. I edged it, though. I actually just put the BB in the same hole on accident. Maybe that was off. Let's do it again. Here, I'll put another marker hole on my target.
What are you, Robin Hood? All right, stay tuned, because coming up next, we got these four going head-to-head in our Air Gunner Challenge right here
on American Air Gunner.
PyramidAir.com. Let's see.
That was fast.
Bingo.
Honey, did you do those chores yet?
Chores?
Lawn. Roger, put that drink down. We got a mow. Chop, chop.
Oh, yeah. He's out there showing the grass he's boss.
Pyramid Air. Big selection, fast shipping, the air gun experts.
All right, guys, so here's what we're gonna have to do today. It's a little challenge we like to call Shredder. And the object is to shred your target literally in half and it falls to the ground. Using this little baby right here. This is the Umarex EBOS, which stands for Electronic Burst of Steel. It is a automatic BB gun. It has an 88 gram CO2 cartridge and of course holds six AA batteries. Holds 360 BBs and 24 in the magazine right here. The cool thing is also, you can put it at a one or burst of 4 or 8 shots. So it's kind of up to the shooter on what they want to do. It should go, and we'll see, something like this. I'm gonna go with, of course, a burst of 8, right? Why not? Fire, and here we go. After you shoot your first rounds, you've got to open up your cartridge right here, and then what we like to call is the BB shimmy shake. And then you're ready to go again. So, it's gonna be interesting. Obviously, it's gonna take a lot of time. I'm not gonna waste mine. Let's get to the challenge. You guys are gonna have unlimited amounts of BBs. First winner shredded is gonna be our winner, and of course, the last two will go to the elimination. Any questions? Nope. You guys feel good?
Yep.
Who feels like they're gonna win this challenge?
Hey! Woo!
Bob, I love the excitement. All right, guys, head over to your spots and let's get this thing started. Good luck. All right, shooters, do not stop shooting until you have shred your target completely in half. I don't care what place you feel like you're at, okay? All right, shooters, ready?
Ready.
All right, looks like everyone's going with the single shot. Interesting. Amanda's doing the shimmy shake here, trying to get some more BBs. Sparky's really moving through this thing. Interesting, they're all going with the, someone's moved to the automatic. But they're all going with the single shot right now. This is not what I expected. Mr. Loco down here in the crouch position. Bob's really pinpointing that middle area. Amanda's a little all over the place right now, but she's doing all right.
The BB guns like that are not my strong point. I just don't think those require as much skill as some of the other guns out here.
There's more of this than there's more than less of this. Oh, Amanda goes down to the crouch position to get a little better angle. Bob's doing some serious damage here in the middle of his target. Mr. Loco's changing out his CO2 cartridge right now.
I ran out of CO2 once, got stressed out, broke off the grip, and just caught myself off guard.
Uh-oh. Sparky's getting some serious damage done down over here. Oh, and there you go, Sparky, well done. Cleans his, Sparky, step back, good job.
Feeling phenomenal right now. I was just so happy to see that paper drop first. And
looks like Mr. Loco's back. Back in business over here. Bob is so close, Bob is so close. There's a race right here. Bob, Mr. Loco, Amanda.
Mine's not shooting at all.
Change your CO2. Oh, this is coming down the wire. And there you go, Bob, well done. Bob just shredded his target. Amanda and Mr. Loco going at it here. Mr. Loco's is just hair, it's literally hanging by threads over here. Amanda has a huge hole in the middle of, oh, and there you go, Mr. Loco's fell. All right, guys, guns down, ceasefire. All right, guys, step back up here. Well, good shooting, everybody. It looked like a couple of you guys had some problems. Amanda, you got stuck on safe over there?
Yeah.
Bob, you moved through that thing pretty good. What were you thinking going through that?
Make it fall.
Yeah, you did that. Well done. Congratulations. Mr. Loco, you had some problems over here. It looks like you popped your handle off and you had to rechange your CO2 cartridge. What was going on over here?
Oh, well, first I thought it was the batteries because the thing just stopped shooting all together.
Yeah.
So I had to switch the CO2 out. Then when I was loading it back up, man, I was so stressed. I just popped the thing off. I was like, screw it. And he was improvising. Yeah.
Sparky, our winner, finally gets one. He drew number one and he got number one. Congratulations, sir. So, interesting turn of events here. Obviously, Sparky and Bob, you guys were our first two, so you will be safe. That means next week, the two people who won the first two competitions, Mr. Loco and Amanda, will be going head-to-head in the Elimination Challenge. Guys, this is gonna be a wild shootout. I can't wait to see what happens next week. That's it for this episode of American Air Gunner. Make sure you tune back in next week. We get a great hunt. And of course, we got the elimination round between Amanda and Mr. Loco on the Airgunner Challenge. We'll see you next week.